Brakes are important. When they don't work, it's bad. I already reinstalled my bell crank, and I just wanted to give a little video on how simple and easy it is, and maybe a couple of the gotchas that'll help you reinstall it if you really want to. My dealer was booked out 3 to 6 months for an actual recall, and they wouldn't give me the part for free, so I just paid for it. And I know there are a lot of alternatives out there, so if you want to get one of those, you can install it yourself pretty easily. Step one, we're going to need to be able to pull the parking brake off. So I dropped down the loader, added a couple of rubber chocks, just find your level of risk aversion and comfort, and make it so you don't get squished. 13 millimeter socket or wrench, long screwdriver with a end we can pry the retaining clip off of, and then just something to brace that pedal. So the bell crank on the opposite side of this rod and pedal is under tension with the screws right now. So to pull the screws out easier, you're gonna run a relieve tension on this foot pedal. I just take a piece of wood, and now that's pushing that way. And now when you release the bolts on the bell crank, this leverage of the pedal isn't gonna make things difficult. If we're looking at the back wheel, if we come underneath the tractor, the bell cranks, we're gonna be right here. And you'll see there's those two bolts, those are 13 millimeter. And then up at the top, I'll switch to another view. You'll see the linkage that has a retaining pin and a washer on the other side. This is the new one. Yours is gonna look different if it's the old one. If you buy the stock part, this is what it'll look like. If you buy other parts, the orifices are gonna be the same in the interface points. When you're pulling these bolts off, we've already tensioned this rod, and for any tension on the opposite direction, you can grab onto this linkage and just push forwards to alleviate the tension for these two bolts for both out and in. For my model of 2019, both the pedal and the bell crank cap screws come in at 15 to 22 foot-pounds as their torque rating. This pin, retaining pin, right here, initially I went for my diagonals to just slap it off because I thought it was a cotter pin. It is not. Let me show you how to pop that off. Get your screwdriver, pop it in here on this side, and just leverage that end of the pin upwards. And it will pop out like that. And once we've done that, we can take our screwdriver from the other direction and just pop it outwards. And boom, it's off. It looks way more intimidating than it actually is. And to put it back on, let me reposition my arm. We're gonna come in with that straight point.
Don't forget to put your washer back on before you put the pin on.
Line that up, and then come in up so that you'll see that little piece ramps up onto the top of the end of the connector. Just push inwards and snap it in, and then you're good to go. All right, and then obviously check your brakes, make sure they work before you go going all crazy out there. Hope that helps, should be pretty simple. And I'm sorry if you were like me and the dealer wouldn't give you the part for free and you had to pay $40, but at least my brakes work.